Santa, and welcome to StreamATL.net. I'm your host, Lateka S. Carter, also known as Diva's Boss Lady, and you're on the guest list. We're currently at the Georgia Aquarium, where FX will be premiering their new hit show, and yes, I did say hit because I believe it's going to be a hit, called Atlanta, where Donald Glover is the executive producer. Don't forget, you're watching StreamATL.net. I'm your host, Lateka Carter, and you're on the guest list. Are you excited about being here and being a female DJ?
Yes, I'm very excited, and I'm so happy that FX invited me out today. I think this is going to be a great TV show for the music community, and I can't wait to see it. So I had to come and show support.
All right. So what are you anticipating happening? And also give the people the information on where they can find you.
Well, I'm anticipating like greatness out of this show. I hope it lasts for a long time. It's definitely needed. And you can find me on social media at I am DJ Superstar. Spin the cam. You can just do, Google DJ Superstar.
All right. Thank you, DJ Superstar. You're on the guest list, StreamATL.net. All right, you're on the guest list, Stream ATL. We have the beautiful DJ Dime piece. All right, do you have any music or anything going on in the actual premiere? Or
you know what? I'm being a DJ and a radio personality. I actually play Donald Glover. We know him as, you know, Childish Gambino. Play his music in my mixes and everything. So now I get to see him beyond the artist, but from the acting and producing perspective. So I'm really excited.
All right, we're excited too. Now, can anyone find any of your music or anything that you're doing out there online? And tell them how.
Absolutely, of course. DJDimePiece.com, the way it's spelled. If you're in Ohio, Cincinnati, you can hear me on 101.1 Wiz, and in Columbus, Ohio, you can hear me on Power 107.5.
All right, we appreciate you. Can't wait to see the show. Enjoy. Yes. Don't forget, you're on the guest list. All right, we're here with one of the DJs. I'm assuming that you're going to be part of the after party. Is that correct?
Yes, I am.
All right, if you can give the audience your name, please, and where you're from.
Chicago, DJ Sean Mack, iHeartRadio, 107.5, WGCI, you know, from Chi-Town.
Chi-Town, are you excited about tonight?
Yes, I am. Yeah, I'm definitely excited about tonight. I've been a fan of Childish Gambino for a long time. I think he's a genius on different levels, and I'm really excited about the premiere and seeing what this is all about. You know, I've been hearing about it, so real excited. FX, they always do their thing, and you know, I'm here to check out. So I'm here to
do your thing, right?
Yeah.
Welcome to On the Guest List, Stream ATL, and we're here with one of the DJs. You're with T.I., correct?
Yes,
Sean Hendricks. Tell us, are you excited about what's going on with this new show coming to FX?
Oh, most definitely. Like, FX has all the greatest, like, thriller shows. And for them to put a show that's, like, showcasing how it is on the music scene in Atlanta is, like, crazy.
Okay. Now, do you have anything that you are putting out there now with your music and where people can find you?
Most definitely. I just put up my new SoundCloud. I know I'm like very late, but I'm just starting to add more music on my SoundCloud. I added a couple of songs off of my last EP called Official, which you can get on iTunes, Spotify, Amazon, wherever, social media based music site, whatever. So I'm working.
How did you get hooked up with T.I.?
It actually was a funny situation. Back in 08, I was a young kid at the back of Phillips Arena waiting for T.I., and I seen him. I saw my opportunity. I ran up to him. At first, you know, he really wasn't trying to entertain me, but, you know, once I had built up the courage and I blocked the door and I said, no one's getting into this man, hears me sing. And after that, he gave me my opportunity. I performed to him. After that, he gave me my shot.
So you sing too?
Yes, I do. I sing. I do it all.
So you're a threat to this industry.
I wouldn't necessarily say that, but you know, I'm coming with it. You know, trust me. You know what I'm saying? I don't want to be no threat. I want to just be here and do what I love to do. You know, that's which is entertain, period. You know what I mean?
Well, we can't wait to see what's going to be taking place. Are you going to be doing anything in the after party here?
I'm not for sure, but if I am, I most definitely will stick around. I mean, it's Atlanta all day.
Okay. All right. Well, we appreciate you being on the guest list with Stream ATL. Welcome to On the Guest List. We're here with some cast members of Atlanta. If you can introduce yourself to our audience, please.
Sure. Hey, my name is Chris Green, and I play Nathan Wilder in Atlanta.
Hi, I'm Candace B. Harris. I play Zesto's cashier in Atlanta.
All right. So how was it to actually be in this show? How was it for you? How did you feel the experience?
It was great. Donald's a creative genius, as most people know, so it was just a lot of fun, a lot of being creative, a lot of positive energy on the set, and just going out to have fun as actors. It's sometimes you don't get a chance to really have fun because of time constraints and schedule, and you know, he worked it out, but Donald was just like, all right, we're going to shoot this take and just let you guys do what you do. So that was great.
So what is your take on it?
Absolutely, I agree with him. It was a lot of fun. We were given an opportunity to improv and go back to forth and put our own personality into our characters. So I really, really enjoyed it.
So you felt improv-ing made you feel better to be who you are?
Absolutely, especially with my character. And, you know, it was a situation where I was trying to give him a hard time ordering food. And I was like, you know, you broke, you know. And so I was going back and forth with the whole, like, you broke and trying to embarrass him in front of the customer. So it was a lot of fun.
Did you all, are you all from here?
Yes, I'm born and raised.
I'm from New York originally, but I'm now kind of a back and forth resident between here and Florida. But I've visited Atlanta. My mother actually lived not too far outside of Atlanta in Kennesaw, which is kind of up in the sticks. Yeah. But so I used to come to Atlanta frequently because obviously there was nothing to do out there. No offense to Kennesaw. I love y'all. But Atlanta, you know, it's stuff to do.
Now.
Exactly.
All right. Now, since you've been visiting and you have been here, have you seen any type of issues that you feel should be addressed when it comes to Atlanta?
Me visiting, no. I mean, I think the cool thing about Atlanta is it is a city, in particular, for African Americans to come and thrive, and businesses are doing well. So I love that aspect to where, you know, you can be a young black professional and come here and start your own business, and actually there are opportunities afforded to you. And then the culture is great. It reminds me a little bit of New York when I come here. That's why I like Atlanta, because it's so diverse and the culture is so strong here, and I love it.
Yeah, we definitely have our charm, and I really don't want Atlanta to lose that, because a lot of people are moving here because it's affordable, and it's so hard up north and out west that people come here and they start winning because everything is accessible to you. So I really don't want us to lose our charm and to become like New York or L.A. I think we just need to add a little bit of spice from each city and just keep that charm.
Keep our uniqueness.
Yeah, keep our uniqueness, absolutely.
Now, one more question. Been on the set a lot of times. How long did it take you all to actually do this show?
There's a term in the industry, or a saying in the industry, called hurry up and wait, because it does take a while to get everything set up. So when you guys see, you know, a half hour, an hour long show or a 30-second commercial, whatever, you don't realize that it does take a full day to get that in and have it looking good. So, but the thing about it, I mean, as artists, we love it. You know, it's you know, we get to spend time on set and actually utilize our creative juices. So, you know, the time really, for me, it goes by. Like, it doesn't seem like a long 8 to 12 to 13 hour day. It goes by pretty quick for me.
All right. Now, what about you?
A quick day would be an 8 hour day. That would be a real quick day. Yeah. So, in filming, but definitely it was a long, quick day, I guess. And
all right. Did you all contribute anything to the show? Any of your ideas or anything like that?
Our skill set, man. That's what we do. No, I mean, that's the cool thing, like I said about Donald, is he allows you to, if you have an idea or, you know, say, hey, Donald, I was thinking about this. He was pretty open to it. I mean, he had his ideas for the script, but as actors, he let us put our own kind of stamp on the character. So,
yeah, and I skipped into a few jokes or two that was from the dome. So that was pretty much my input.
Cool. We cannot wait to see it. Thank you so much. You've been with Stream ATL on the guest list.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
you're on the guest list. We have another phenomenal and beautiful woman here. I'm going to let her introduce herself to you.
Hi, my name's Janina Gavankar.
Are you from here, from Atlanta?
Oh, no. I'm actually in town working on Sleepy Hollow right now.
Do you like Sleepy Hollow?
My favorite.
Oh, thank God.
One of my favorites, sir.
You're the first person that I've met that watches the show. Yay.
Yay. All right.
I hope you like this season.
I'm sure I will. I'm sure I will. Now, you said that you were excited about seeing this. Why are you so excited? What do you think it's going to bring to Atlanta and FX?
Oh, my gosh. I have so much to say about that. I've been excited about this show since they announced development. I love FX. I've worked for FX before. And they're sort of like HBO. They don't put a bunch of reins on you. And Donald, I know the word genius gets overused, but he's a genius. He's a multidisciplinary, very serious artist, and anything that he makes, I will watch. Anything. And he's standing right over there, and I'm kind of dying.
Me too. All right, if you can let the audience know how to find you or follow you. I'm sure you may have a Twitter or an Instagram or anything like that.
All of the above. I'm on Twitter at Janina. I'm on Instagram at Janina. And I'm on Facebook at Janina Gavankar.
Thank you so much for being a part of On the Guest List.
Got him. How you look when you high at work?
All right, you're on the guest list with StreamATL.net. Now, I'm going to let this handsome gentleman introduce himself to you all.
Hi, I'm Brian Tyree Henry. I play Alfred Paperboy Mouse.
Paperboy Mouse? All right, so what can the audience expect to see in this character?
Themselves, their family, people they love, their homies, the people that are right next to them. I mean, I feel like Paperboy is going to be the representation of those people who aren't normally represented on TV, and I want that to reach as far and wide as I can. You know, you've got your Paperboys in Atlanta, you got your Paperboys in Philly, D.C. I want all of them to see that I'll be up there representing them, you know.
All right. Did you give any input in this show when you got casted?
Donald is pretty much a genius in my book. He'll try to deny that, but he's pretty much like he's a genius. And all I wanted to bring to it is the truth and the fun of who this character is, you know what I mean? And, you know, I used to live here, and I feel like once you live in Atlanta, it don't ever leave you, you know what I mean? So I wanted to make sure that I showcased that, you know?
Well, we appreciate you. Can't wait to see the show. Thank you so much. You're on the guest list with StreamATL.net.
Oh, yeah.
We're on the guest list here at the premiere for Atlanta, and we have these two handsome gentlemen here. If you introduce yourself to our audience.
I'm Paul Sims. I'm one of the executive producers, and this is my buddy Hero, the director, also a producer.
Hero Murray, I'm a director for the show.
He directed all the episodes.
Yeah. No, it's all right.
All right. Now, what was it like for you when Donald came and presented this idea to you?
He already had the script written, and he gave it to me to read, and it was one of the best scripts I've ever read, and having not... I'd only been to Atlanta once when I was a kid, and I thought this is a fascinating world that I'd love to spend time with in real life and see on TV, and it felt so authentic, and you can tell when someone's writing really from their heart and really writing about their own lives, and even though it was a world I didn't know anything about, I wanted to see more of it.
Oh, well, I thank you for doing that. Now, what about you? When you heard about this idea, what were the thoughts going through your mind?
I mean, I thought, you know, this is a show where I would get to see Atlanta in a way that I've never seen before on television. I don't think, you know, Atlanta gets represented in this light often. And it seemed like such a great creative opportunity to make something different and interesting.
One last question. What do you hope the audience will take away from this show?
I hope the people who like it feel like it... Even if they're not from Atlanta, they feel like that's sort of like my life a little bit. And I feel like then the other people who are very different like me go like, wow, that's a crazy world. And it's fun to spend a half hour in it every week.
Okay. You're with Stream ATL on the guest list, and we have one of the cast members of Atlanta here. If you'll tell the audience who you are and who you play.
I am my mom and my father personified. I play Darius.
He played Darius. What can we expect out of your character on the show?
I don't know what to say.
Now, we've heard a lot about how Mr. Glover allowed everyone to be able to do their own part, to be a part of who they were. Was that something that you really enjoyed, and did you really bring your true character to this particular character?
My true character, like the character I'm playing, is always being revealed to me. If it's not, then I know I'm doing something wrong. It's always about growth. And this character, for me, is constantly going through different states and changes that are revealing themselves. And so I just jump around in that and be a part of that. This character is taking me on a ride as much as I'm taking that character on a ride. I'm getting to explore the more quirky, interesting sides of human nature and be a part of that. So, yeah, it's a beautiful thing. And every character I play is a part of me because it kind of has to be.
All right. That's awesome. Now, if you'll tell the people how they can find you and connect with you online.
Get off the internet and go outside and play.
I heard that. Now, any talents that you want to do for our audience?
Any talents?
Yeah. I saw you over there. I didn't know if you were singing or rapping or anything like that.
Oh, I can shake my dreads. And not have this.
He's giving us something we can feel, right?
I jump up out the water like.
He jump up out the water like. All right. Well, we appreciate it. Can't wait to see you on the screen. I know you're excited about what's happening here. Thank you so much for your time.
Nice. Life itself is but a series of close calls.
Welcome to StreamATL.net. You're on the guest list. Now, we have this beautiful woman here. Can you please introduce yourself to the audience?
Hey, everybody. It's your favorite, your girl, D. Woods.
D. Woods. All right. Now, you're a cast in this show, correct?
No, I'm not. But okay. Hopefully soon, you know, we got our agents working on that part.
I'm speaking it then. Now, just to let you know, we were trying to figure out where we've seen you before, like in a group or anything like that.
You see me in groups, you see me on TV, you see me on stage, you hear me through your speakers, you see me on your social media. Your girl D. Woods, you know, platinum selling artist, actress, dancer. I do it all, you know, I'm a triple threat.
I like that, triple threat. Now, what makes you really want to see this show? What are you looking forward to?
I'm definitely looking forward to just seeing another story, an authentic story of us on TV. I'm really happy for Donald Glover, a.k.a. Childish Gambino. You know what I'm saying? No limitations. You know, he's doing music, he's acting, he's writing, he's producing. And that's what we need more of. So I really want to support him and support us. And I hope everybody else does the same thing, because we complain that we're not on the Oscars and we're not at the Emmys and whoop-de-whoop-de-whoop. But we really got to get out there and make sure that we're writing the content and we're supporting the content when it comes out. So that's why I'm here.
All right. With Atlanta, what issues have you seen and what would you think needs to be done?
Well, I mean, the film industry is definitely booming here. It's definitely found a new home. But I read the synopsis of this story, and I think it's a real story for a lot of people who are in the music industry, who are aspiring to be in the entertainment industry. And, you know, there's a lot of bumps and bruises, and all that glitters is not gold. And it's just good to see a real story about that. Like, we all aren't drug dealers. We all aren't, you know, ball players. Some of us just have a dream. We just want to be creative. And it ain't easy all the time. Sometimes the overnight success is like 10 years. So...
If you could just give an encouraging word to those artists or the actress, actor, or someone who is looking to do that, you're already a triple threat. If you could give them some encouraging words to let them know to stay inspired and motivated.
Well, just have to remember why you wanted to do it in the first place. Like, it wasn't a mistake that you woke up that day and decided that you love to sing, you love to dance, you love to write, you love to, you know, create. You know, that's our gift, and we got to share our gift with the world. So just keep finding places where you can put your gift out there.
She's awesome. Thank you so much for allowing us to interview you. We appreciate you.
My pleasure.
Bye. Bye. You're with StreamATL.net, and you're on the guest list. And look at this gentleman here. I'm going to let him introduce you to.
Hey, how you doing? I'm Kawan Prather. Most people call me KP. I'm head of music at I Am Other, a company that's headed by Pharrell Williams and a member of the Dungeon family. You know, I'm from Atlanta.
From Atlanta. You heard that? All right. So what brings you out other than wanting to see the show? What really intrigued you to want to be here tonight?
Because I think Donald's extremely talented, so I wanted to see what his vision of Atlanta is in this show. Mm-hmm. You know, that simple.
Now, you've been in Atlanta. You say you're from here. What, I know there's a lot of issues and everything, but what issue stands out the most to you that you feel needs to be addressed?
In?
Whatever.
The most? Oh, man.
Was that a loaded question?
It's a broad question. What issues need to be addressed the most? Employment. Yeah, employment is a big issue. I feel like you get more jobs, you get people off the streets, you get people not looking at mine, trying to take mine, they have their own.
I agree with that. Now, you're in the music industry. To that thriving artist or that producer or anyone who wants to do what you're doing and been privy to do, what advice would you give them?
I think you have to take the time to learn the craft, take the time to learn like some history of the thing that you want to do. I think a lot of times people jump into things so fast that they fumble because they just weren't ready. And there are a lot of talented people who, based on the internet, can be seen, but you don't also always want to be seen practicing.
That's good stuff. If you don't mind, if you can tell the audience where they can find you or follow you.
You can follow me at my government name, at Kawan Prather, KawanPrather, on any of the social media stuff. And, you know, and listen to music. We're there.
All right. We appreciate you taking the time to be a part of this on the guest list with Stream ATL.
Hey, what's up, y'all? It's your girl, Carly Red. We're here at Streamline Radio.
All right. Now, I'm going to tell you, this woman right here, she got it going on. Now, your character on Love and Hip Hop brings to that show.
Well, I wouldn't say it's a character. What it is it's me, but it's my life, you know, just I'm giving to people what really happens in my life. My life is crazy. Yeah, and it gets even crazier and crazier and crazier. But, yeah, it's just what happens when, you know, you're dating love and hip-hop.
How does it really feel to do a show like this where the camera is always following you, you don't really have a break, and everything is laid out.
I love it. I mean, we have the opportunity to showcase our work. We have the opportunity to really put what's going on in our life, and the audience loves it, so I'm not complaining.
I know that's right. So you're looking forward to seeing this show, Atlanta. What are you really looking forward to and hoping that it will bring to the table?
I don't want to expect the worst or expect anything out of it. I want to see what's going to happen. And I'm dying to see it. Bring them peaches on, honey.
Sounds good. Now, if you want to tell the audience how they can follow you.
No problem. So on Instagram, I am Carly Red. Twitter, Carly Red. It's Facebook, Carly Red. You already know. CarlyRed.com. But it was nice meeting you.
You too. Thank you. You're here, StreamATL.net, on the guest list. Check him out. You see what he doing, right? We're here with Bobby V. Tell us, look at him. He got so much energy right now. We appreciate you coming out. So what made you come out to want to support Atlanta?
Well, I'm from Atlanta, you know. I wasn't born here, but I was raised in the A. And I've seen so much great promotion on Atlanta, you know, from every channel to everything. So I wanted to come out and show Donald Glover, a.k.a. Childish Gambino, some love on what he's doing, you know, as far as the arts and entertainment. And, you know, I just want to see. I actually have a movie myself coming out called Hollywood Hearts, and the soundtrack will be out. They'll both be out in October. It'll be on a major network. And so I wanted to come out and show love and support and also take some of this goodness in that's going on in Atlanta.
I know that's right. What can people expect to see in your movie that you have coming out?
It's kind of like it's my rendition of Purple Rain. You know, it's not a true story, but it's a story about me. So it's kind of like my Purple Rain. So I'm excited about it. And it'll be out real soon on a major network.
We can't wait to see
Hollywood
it.
Hearts.
Hollywood Hearts. You hear that? Do you want to drop a note before you leave? Okay.
Go check this movie out.
We appreciate you, Bobby B. All right. You heard it here on streamatl.net. You're on the guest list with your host, Lateka Carter.
Why are you up?
I had a weird dream.
Yo, $62 is plenty enough to go on a date, man.
Passengers on flight 4057, please proceed gate number 23.
Life itself is but a series of close calls. I mean, how would you know you were alive unless you knew you could die?
Lemon pepper joints, but these got the sauce on them.
Smoke.
Patience, young Vanessa.
Do you have the Miller High Life? Like the ones in the can?
We got a hipster. Okay.
Hey, y'all. What'd you call y'all group, man?
We the Migos.
Yeah. The four Migos. We're inseparable.
And this nigga I ain't seen 11 years come up to my man, listen. Hey, boy, I ain't seen you about 11 years, boy, let's hang out. Go get a beer.
Man, it was a hard day.
You like it?
I love it.
Atlanta. You're here with StreamATL.net. You're on the guest list, and we're here with DJ Sean Mack after the premiere of the FX show Atlanta. How did you like the show?
I like the show. I like both parts of the show. I thought it was dope. I thought the it was refreshing. It was something new. Seeing FX kind of take a curve into that direction with the plot of the whole thing. I thought it was dope, and the fact that they filmed it here was awesome. The everything that they were doing about it was kind of cool. The skits in between. I'm not sure if those skits were going to be in the show or is it? But that's going to be hilarious if it is. And looking forward to seeing more and seeing what the outcome is going to be with rolling out with the other episodes.
Okay. Now, what do you feel the audience at home is going to think about this show overall?
I'm not sure. It might be. Everybody has a different opinion on it. If you're in the hip hop culture, I think people are going to like it. You know what I'm saying? I think people are going to like it personally. I think personally, people. Everybody's probably going to have a different opinion on different things. But I think it was really good overall, and I think people were going to pretty much enjoy it, for the most part.
All right. Well, thank you so much for your interview. I hope you enjoy the after party. We appreciate you. You're on the guest list, StreamATL.net.
All right.
Thank you so much.
Appreciate
it.
Hi, guys. My name is Rosalyn. I'm here with my girl,
Jasmine.
And we just saw Atlanta. So wanted to give you a quick overview, or not even an overview, just our little critique on it. And personally, I thought it was great, hilarious, definitely some moments where you do some realizations, which is good. You know, you want to keep us thinking and all that good stuff. So I'm going to leave it to Jasmine to tell you what she thought.
Yeah, I thought there was a great plot line. It was really funny, had us laughing. The theater was cracking up. So go ATL.
Welcome back, Atlanta. You're here with Lateka Carter, aka Divas Boss Lady, on the guest list. Now we have the producer of FX, new show, comedy show, great show, Atlanta. How well do you think the audience took the show?
I think they liked it. I mean, it's just great to see people in Atlanta actually seeing a show made in Atlanta, starring people from Atlanta, written by people in Atlanta, filmed by people in Atlanta. It was very fun.
All right. Do you feel that the world is ready for this type of show?
I guess we'll find out. I mean, I think the world is ready. It's weird. It's different because, on TV, you usually watch TV at home on your, in your living room or wherever. It's weird seeing it in a big audience room with a big audience, but it was exciting for us.
All right. Well, I'm not going to hold you. I know you want to go back to the after party. Congratulations to you. I enjoyed the show, and I'm a fan of FX, so thank you.
Thank you.
All right. You heard it here, ladies and gentlemen. StreamATL.net on the guest list.